So here's Perez. Perez, center field. Hit very well. Venable on the move. Venable dives, and he makes the catch. A game-saving catch. And that'll end the inning. What a play by Will Venable to send this game to the 13th.
Talk about full extension. Holy smokes, what a play.
Back here on a special opening day edition of the MLB pregame show. Matt Vasgersian here counting down the minutes until the new season gets underway. And before it does, we'll check out our first Topps player spotlight. Number 17 will be our focus, as he's coming off a year in which he led the American League in wins. And I'm sure he'll tell you it's a lot more complex than simply pitching better than his opponent on most days.
Yeah, you know, it takes a lot to rack up enough wins to lead the league. You need durability, the ability to pitch deep into games, and ideally a strikeout pitch to go along with it. Of course, you can have all those things and more, but you're also dependent on other factors that you can't control, things like run support. Regardless, he put together a great campaign a year ago, and he's going to try to repeat that this year.
All right, lineups and first pitch are coming up next. Stay tuned for that right here on the show. From the home of the Rangers, there's a good look at Globe Life Park here in Arlington. Opening night here in this brand new season between the Boston Red Sox and the Texas Rangers. Hi again, everybody. It's finally here. Welcome to our special opening day edition of Baseball on the Show. Joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, as we get set to get things going, it's the pitching that has to be considered one of the strong points on this ball club.
Yeah, and pitching is going to be important for these guys, no question about it. They're only going to go as far as this group right here is going to take them. And to me, it looks like a staff that's capable of getting the job done.
The date that's been circled for weeks is finally here. It's opening night. It's the show. And it's coming up next. Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
Now taking the field, welcome your 2015 Texas Rangers.
And before we get too much further, here's a look at each manager's starting lineup here for the opener. They'll go to work against the Japanese import, the hard-throwing right-hander Yu Darvish. And in the field behind him, the Rangers will look like this. Elvis Andrews will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Elvis Andrews.
and he pours this one in at the letters, 0-1.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
Fastball right back to the mound, and he'll flip on to first to record the out. Ramon Jimenez will stand in for the first time here. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
That's a two-seam fastball right there. It looks to the hitter like it's going to be inside, and then it tails back to the inside corner of the plate.
Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
Well, you always want to avoid using a lot of energy in the early part of the game, and he's taking that to heart. Five pitches and two outs already here in the bottom of the first.
Prince Fielder will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So they go down without a whimper here. On to the second inning now from Arlington. Mitch Moreland will start things off in the bottom of the second. First pitch to him. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, you got to figure that this guy's going to come out here free and easy here in the second. He's got a three-run cushion already. No reason not to come right after these guys.
And this is fouled straight back. Now a fastball, and he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. Shin-Soo Chu will step in now. And this is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Another 0-2 coming. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning. Adrian Beltre will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. A called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing and one.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
And that'll qualify as the Rangers' first hit. So a runner at first with two away. And standing in now, the right fielder, Alex Rios. And this is going to be a foul ball. Two out with the man at first. And that's cut on and missed by Rios that time. 0-2 now.
Yeah, you've got a cold night. The ball won't be carrying as well. So you can afford to take a few more chances in the strike zone and challenge some guys. In that case, up in the strike zone.
And yet another foul ball here as this finds the seats and the count will remain at 0-2. Here comes another 0-2. Swing and he shatters the bat as this is hit on the ground. But this will be a foul ball and it's still 0-2. That's hit hard on the ground, and it'll make it through into right field for a two-out single. Throw will hold that runner at second base, and now there are two on with two out. Jurickson Profar is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. And a fastball just misses. It's 1-1. Two men are on with two men out. Oh, he took a big swing that time as he lifts a high pop-up. Drifting into foul territory on the right side. And over near the... Giovanni Soto makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
Well, he's gotten away here early with leaving some of these pitches out over the middle of the plate, especially to start some of these at-bats.
Now a ball lined toward right center. And Soto's aboard. He's got himself a base hit. Elvis Andrews will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul strike one. And And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Fastball got him looking as that had two-seam action on it, one gone. Ramon Jimenez will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. In there for strike one, 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Now, he's probably lucky he didn't make contact on that one.
Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. Nava is over now, and he puts this one away in foul territory, and there are two men out. So two are gone here in the Rangers' third, and that'll bring in the slugging first baseman, Prince Fielder. Oh, and he just blows the fastball by him for strike one. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
Well, that's a good spot for that two-seam fastball. Now, remember, that'll run away from left-handers, so a good idea to work the outside edge.
Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. Victorino is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Mitch Moreland will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Swung right over the top of that one as this is a little dribbler out in front of the mound. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Shin-Soo Chu will get another shot, called out on strikes his first time around. Now he swings and hits this ball on the ground. Throw to first will get him, already two away here in the home fourth.
Yeah, it's not like he needed any help. He's pitching well enough as it is, but this is now two pitches and two outs here in the inning. And he's growing more and more confident with every passing batter.
Adrian Beltre will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head. Alex Rios will come forward now in an RBI opportunity he probably didn't think he'd have.
Yeah, it certainly didn't look like he'd have one, but now's where you really have to make teams pay. Nothing will demoralize a team in the field quite like having two out errors that lead to runs.
Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the... Jurickson Profar will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. There's a fastball to start him off, but that misses for ball one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
And now a ball sliced the other way out to left field. Nava moves over a few steps to his right as he's got it for the first out. Giovanni Soto will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Boy, he has been a first strike throwing machine, hasn't he? He's hardly been behind in the count all game long.
And he pulls the string on another one. He's ahead 0-2 now. And that is swung on and missed by Soto as he can't time that one, and there are two gone now.
A shortstop, number one, Elvis.
Now a ball lying toward the alley in left center. Nava is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the shot. Ramon Jimenez will stand in to lead things off as the top of this batting order really hasn't been much of a factor so far.
Yeah, and between the top three guys in this lineup, no hits between them. And you got to figure you're not going to win too many games when that's the case.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Middlebrooks down at third. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
That changeup's been real effective for him so far. The guys have been falling behind in the count, so they're forced to protect. And this thing looks so good coming out of his hand that they just go ahead and chase after it.
Swinging a hard hit ball down the line in right. Dives, and he hangs on for the out. Wow!
You know, it's always a danger as an outfielder when you try to make a play like this. You worry about that wrist because sometimes you can get it tucked under when you hit the ground and you can twist it up pretty good or maybe even break it. But here, not only does he come away unhurt, but he also comes away with the baseball.
Mitch Moreland will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far. You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark.
Now, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
Swung on and missed. One and two now.
A strike away now from getting through six shutout innings here, and that's no small feat again.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. They trail here 4-0.
Leading out for the Rangers.
Shin-Soo Chu is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Adrian Beltre will stand in. He reached on an error last time through. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
And that gets down out there for Beltre. Could be extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double. Alex Rios will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, that's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Now a good changeup there as this is lifted into the air out towards center field. Victorino is there now, and he has it, two gone. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Jurickson Profar is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. Runners left in. Now, meanwhile, this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. Victorino gets it in, so that holds the runner at third base. Giovanni Soto will come forward now at a great RBI chance here with runners at the corners.
And these opportunities have been few and far between so far. They've got to make something happen soon or this game might just get away from them.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. And now Boston's bullpen springs into action. A left-hander and a right-hander begin to throw. Fouled back. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Elvis Andrews will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
And this is popped foul off to the right and back into the seats. Fastball foul tip, but straight into the catcher's glove as he's able to hang onto it for the first out of the inning. Ramon Jimenez will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
Now a ball pulled softly toward the right side of the field. Over to the bag is Napoli as he handles it himself for the out. Prince Fielder will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
And that's dead center for strike one. Oh, and a big hack by Fielder, just like his daddy, but it's 0-2. Boy, that changeup's had him eaten out of his hand.
Oh, and they've been falling all over themselves trying to get it. But you've just got to know that that's not going to be a strike. It looks like it is, but it isn't.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame. Mitch Moreland will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth because they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so Quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
And a swing as he pulls this one into right. Markakis is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away.
Now batting, left fielder.
Shin-Soo Chu comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Nava is there, and folks are starting to head for the exits now. Two gone here in the ninth. Adrian Beltre will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Throw on to first, and the Red Sox move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch one. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, definitely no debate as far as I'm concerned. He was really in complete control the whole way through. Only really got into trouble a few times, and he winds up with a complete game shutout.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Harris, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. No balls and a strike to the now 39-year-old veteran. Molina swings and misses. He's in trouble now behind 0-2.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
And a swing and a miss and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two. Fouled straight back. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. That's on the inside corner to put him behind here, 0-2.
Now 0-2, you got to be wary of that changeup. This is where he likes to throw it, and it doesn't always have to be a strike.
Hey, let's go, big fellow. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Victorino retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. James Loney will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
First baseman, James.
Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this is foul for the first strike. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Boy, his control has been outstanding so far. And there's another pitch right on the black.
Fouled back.
Hey, get your good one up there, huh? Get your pitches ready. Let's go, big dog.
And yet another foul ball here as this finds the seats, and the count will remain at 0-2. Now another 0-2. And boy, what a battle brewing here as he fouls yet another pitch into the seats. Still stuck on 0-2. Swing and a bouncer out in front. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. Leadoff man retired, and that'll bring in the powerful third baseman, Evan Longoria. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. Now here's a swing and a little bouncer out to the left of the mound. And a barehanded pickup. Throw on to Napoli takes care of him. Two away now. Matt Joyce will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. And this is fouled back and out of play. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Wilson Betemit will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth.
Designated hitter.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. There's his total now, just into his fifth inning of work. Nothing too out of the ordinary there.
Well, the pitch count's the least of his worries. If his guys don't get him any runs, I don't think it'll matter all that much.
David DeJesus will get another shot. Called out on strikes his first time around. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And a dive, but he can't pull it in out in right center. DeJesus on his way to third.
Come on, get down.
And DeJesus is in at third with a triple. Logan Forsythe will dig in here. Took a called third strike his first time. And a called strike down in the zone, 0-1. Any thought to bringing the infield in here with one away?
Still a little early in my book. A run you can live with. What you don't want to do is let this snowball into a big inning.
Come on, big guy. Give me stuff right here.
Got him. And that's eight strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. Jason Nix will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
Off the plate at 94, 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily...
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will... Jose Molina will lead things off as the Rays look to get something going in their half of the sixth. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Checks his swing, but this will be strike two called.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Another 0-2 coming. Now a swing and another ball that I believe will find its way into the seats. Still 0-2.
All right, come on now. Here we go. One time. Let it fly.
And this is going to be a foul ball.
Hey, be patient. Pick one out and drive it, kid.
Yeah! Gets under it a bit as this is hit high in the air out toward left center. Nava will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out. Desmond Jennings will stand in now. He struck out and flied out, 0 for 2 thus far. And this is fouled back and out of play.
All right, come on now. One out. You got one.
Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. And this one will be fouled back in among the fans. Swing and a line drive over Pedroia and into right center for a solid single. James Loney will dig in here. 1 for 2. He's singled and grounded out so far. And he'll take it to the bag for the out. And there's your... Evan Longoria will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh.
Third baseman.
Swung on and missed that time. It's 0-1. Living a little dangerously here.
Yeah, you don't have to go looking for trouble. Trouble will find you if you're putting pitches there.
Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1.
And that's not a bad spot. Just go ahead and stay out there. Don't come down the middle because we know he can hurt you.
And that looked like it caught him squarely in the arm. And the recovery attempt will not be in time, as now the question becomes, how hard did that hit him? Well, this is certainly something you never want to see. Perhaps the silver lining here, if there is one, is that that got him in the non-throwing arm. So if he had to work his way through this, he probably could, assuming, of course, that there's nothing broken in there. And I think he is indeed planning to give it another go. Matt Joyce is at the plate now as he looks at strike one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
Now a fair ball chopped up the line to first.
Come on, beat it out, beat it out.
And they'll just tag him out along the first base line. Wilson Betemir will dig in, needing to find a way to get that go-ahead run in from second base. In there, no balls and a strike.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. That's in there, base hit. Throw comes in quickly here, so that'll hold that go-ahead run at third now with still only one away. David DeJesus will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this would be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
And that is down for extra bases as that ought to plate the go-ahead run and maybe another. And a relay home, and the second run will score as that makes it a 2-0 ball game. Here comes Sox manager John Farrell on his way out to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. And boys, probably a handful of deserving candidates for our Topps Player of the Game Award, but what do you say we go ahead and give it to the man who shut the door out of the pen?
Yeah, it's nice to have someone like this that you can call on to finish things out for you, and he came on to slam the door shut.
So that just about...
Mouth is made of metal, metal, metal. Pocket full of yellow, yellow. Pocket full of gold, and I hope you find your dream. Yeah.
He's got it for the first out. Chris Davis will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. A big uppercut there as he popped this straight up, and I mean way up there on the left side of the infield. He'll take this in without much trouble, and two are gone here to start the fourth.
Yeah, it's not like he needed any help. He's pitching well enough as it is, but this is now two pitches and two outs here in the inning. And he's growing more and more confident with every passing batter.
Swing and a hot shot towards the hole. And that is in there for a two-out base knock. Michael Kadire will get a shot here with two away and a runner at first now following the base hit.
That two-out single seemed harmless enough, but anytime you...
And he gets there as he had a lot of ground to cover that time. J.J. Hardy will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. J.J. Hardy. In the air to left center. Victorino is there to put this one away, and it's a very quick out to start the fifth. Manny Machado will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Swung on and missed that time. It's 0-1.
Well, you see his pitch count on your screen right there. That's not a mistake. He's been loving those first pitch outs, that's for sure.
Oh, and it looks like a visit to the video room may be in order after that hack. It's 0-2 now. And now this is foul tipped at the plate, and that appeared to catch a lot of the home plate umpire in the process. Hope he's all right down there. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. No runs, two hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. And he got him.
I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. And he's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Nelson Rios will get another shot, called out on strikes his first time around. Now a swing and a miss, took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count, it's not even close to being a factor just yet.
Get a good one up there. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Steven Castro will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had them off balance all game.
Now a swing and a ground ball to third. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Jonathan Spahn will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. I tried to hold back on that pitch outside, but went around for strike one. Comes back with a good changeup there, and it's quickly 0-2. Boy, that changeup's had him eaten out of his hand.
Oh, and they've been falling all over themselves trying to get it. But you just got to know that that's not going to be a strike. It looks like it is, but it isn't.
Boy. And in the first two games of this series, he's already struck out a total of four times now. You get to where you just hate taking that walk back to the dugout. I'll tell you, it's a very frustrating feeling.
Jamal Weeks is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A blooper.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire. Chris Davis will dig in. 0 for 2. He's flied out and popped out so far.
Chris Davis.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Boy, he has been a first strike throwing machine, hasn't he? He's hardly been behind in the count all game long.
Come on, baby. See it, drive it. Let's go.
Now he spins on a fastball here and drives one to deep right field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run.
Now batting number 10, center fielder Adam
And a swing and a ball hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Boy, good pitch, good spot. That thing tailed right back over the outside corner.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. Hicks is there and he makes the catch for the out. Michael Kadire will dig with one in and one away. Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. Oh, he looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
That got in his kitchen big time right there.
And this is lined hard to deep left. Hicks is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. J.J. Hardy will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out 0-2 thus far. And this is fouled straight back. Now here's a swing and a ground ball. Throw in time and the side is retired. So one run. Manny Machado will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Gets under it a bit as this is hit high in the air out toward left center. Hicks is in his tracks now, and he's got it for out number one.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
On to first, and he's breezing through the eighth here with two quick outs. Steven Castro will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
And this pitch is hit rather sharply toward the third base coaching box. It's a foul ball. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Jonathan Spahn will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
In there, strike two. And he is down on strikes again. So get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game. Now the first pitch. Line hard. Foul. Right by him here. And he's set up for another strikeout here. The count to 0-2.
Boy, I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this, with the stuff he's got tonight, not a comfortable spot to be in. Let's go, big dog. Your spot.
Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game. Now here's a swing and a ground ball back up the box. Throw one to first, and the Red Sox have taken games one and two here at home as this one is over.
Well, we talked about how they needed a good outing out of this guy, and he gave them that and even more, finishing off the complete game victory.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he really came through with a dominating pitching performance. You see there, 12 strikeouts, and that doesn't even tell the whole story.
your shotgun, cock it back, shoot the sun until the sky is black. Now I sure hope that the sun got rhythm, cause he gon' dance when that music hit him. Like bang, 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 darkness falls, in the nighttime I'm camouflaged. Now I don't know who you are, but girl, I wanna know if you can move like this. And I don't know if you're gonna tell me, but I wanna know what your name is. And you gonna make me fall in love with you if you keep on shaking your hips. Now can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this? I know you think that you can move, but can you groove the way I groove? Grab a slingshot, find a stone, shoot the moon until the night is gone. Now I don't know who you are, but girl, I wanna know if you can move like this. And I don't know if you're gonna tell me, but I wanna know what your name is. And you gonna make me fall in love with you if you keep on shaking your hips. Now can you do this?
This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian. And as
and now, your New York
Brett Gardner will stride in now, and he's up near the top of the American League in stolen bases, currently third entering play. Swing, and he pulls the fastball that time high in the air toward fairly deep right center. And he is going to have extra bases here to start the home first. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double. Eduardo Nunez will stand in for the first time here. And here's a fastball called for strike one. For Gardner, that gives him five doubles now on the year. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count. And he goes after a fastball, but pops it up back behind second base. And Pedroia looks this one in for out number one. Jacoby Ellsbury will get his first opportunity now with that leadoff man still at second here with one gone now. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the pitch home to Ellsbury. And this is cut on and missed by Ellsbury as he becomes out number two. Brian McCann will stand in here for the first. Pick up that runner from second with two away here. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing. And
now, meanwhile, this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. The throw home, and the run is in to score to make this a 1-0 ball game. Mark Teixeira will dig in now. Off to a slow start, as you see there. Just barely over the 200 mark here in April. Now a little dribbler here off to the right side of the mound. And he'll just make the tag himself in the... Francisco Cervelli will stand in as one of the stars from yesterday's ball game as he had three hits in the victory. Now a swing and a ground ball back up the middle. And a dive there from Pedroia, but he comes up empty. It's a base hit. Kelly Johnson will get his first shot now. He, too, had three knocks in yesterday's win. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. And the 1-1 is in the air now out to center. And this is taken in out there by Victorino for out number one. Scott Hairston. He'll take his first cuts here with the runner still at first and one away now. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. Two straight fastballs now as he powers ahead 0-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Another 0-2 coming. And yet another foul ball here as this finds the seats and the count will remain at 0-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now this is foul tipped right into the catcher's glove as he holds on to preserve the strikeout, and there are two away. Brendan Ryan is in with two away here as this one swung on and missed for the first strike.
That first pitch change can be a tough one. A guy doesn't have it.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to... Brett Gardner will get his second shot at it now. He doubled to start out the home first. Now he tried to hold back, but this is popped up. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Fouled back. And this is swung on and missed as Gardner's a strikeout victim, one away. Eduardo Nunez will try it again. He flew out his first time. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. And this is going to be a foul ball.
Hey, let's go now one time.
Here we go. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2.
Hey, let her fly, kid.
And his 0-2 is bounced on the ground to third. Throw on to Napoli, takes care of him. Two away now. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring in the center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury. A bit high there. A ball and no strikes. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Now a swing and another chance at third. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Brian McCann will start things out here for the Pinstripers, to be followed by Mark Teixeira on deck. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Seems like he's gotten away with more than a few location mistakes so far.
Yeah, and that's not going to last forever, especially in this place.
Now a ground ball here just to the left of second. Throw on to first in time, one away. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And here's the dangerous Mark Teixeira. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. One run on three hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away. Francisco Cervelli will dig in. He singled his first time around, and he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
A lot of these guys have come into these at-bats trying to be the aggressor, trying to make something happen. But what has happened...
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end... Kelly Johnson will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. Oh, and he's waiting on the fastball that time as he belts one high and deep to right center. And out of here! Scott Hairston will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Boy, he goes right back to that same pitch that he just gave up a home run on. Put it in another dangerous location, too. Lucky he got away with that one.
And this is fouled back and out of play. And slowly hit to the right side. On to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. And this ball will be chopped foul. Grounded foul off to the right and over toward the dugout. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone. Brett Gardner will step in. One for two in the ballgame. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. And this will be fouled away. And this is going to be a foul ball. The next 0-2. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back. Two runs, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. And this is going to be a foul ball in amongst the spectators. Now a fastball as this is hit fairly well out toward left center. And Victorino will make the catch and the inning is over. So one run, on one base hit, the home run, no errors, and no one left.
Leading off for the Yankees.
Eduardo Nunez is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. And he takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Fouled straight back. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Fouled back. Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Jacoby Ellsbury will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone. Brian McCann is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark. Well, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
And he stays alive as this is grounded foul. Now another 0-2. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. And boy, what a battle brewing here as he fouls yet another pitch into the seats. Still stuck on 0-2. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Mark Teixeira will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. In there, and it's 0-1. In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
some would say he's showing good patience here, waiting for his pitch. But as a number five hitter, I think you need to make something happen.
And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the seventh. Here comes Sox manager John Farrell on his way out to the mound. And he's looking to the bullpen here, so it would appear that's all for his starter tonight. The big bat for the Red Sox tonight, well, it belonged to this man, Nick Markakis. Picture perfect there. He's our Topps player of the game.
Well, he winds up with three quarters of the cycle.
Jonathan Spahn will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Leading off for the Orioles, designated hitter, Jonathan
Spahn. And he misses inside with that one, ball one. First two pitches off the mark here, it's 2-0.
This is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. That alone can be beneficial to an offense.
This is sharply hit back up the middle, and the leadoff man is going to reach here. He's got a base hit.
So far, so good. They get a scoreless top of the first, and now a leadoff single to start things in their half.
Michael Kadire will get his first shot now, and you can see how he's done over the course of this five-game hitting streak. Now a big swing as this is popped up. And I mean way up there toward the right side of the infield. And there to take this is Napoli for the first out. Chris Davis will get his first cuts here. And the danger's obvious as he currently leads the American League in home runs. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Oh, and that is right there for strike two.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out. Adam Jones will dig in, and the season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. And Jones takes this one for a ball, 1-1. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now.
Oh, a very hittable pitch, too. That's a middle-of-the-plate fastball, and he's not going to get away with too many of those tonight.
Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. J.J. Hardy will start things off in the bottom of the second. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything.
And he'll have himself a leadoff single as this is through into left. Nolan Reimold will stand in. In there for strike one, 0-1.
Straight paint at 94 miles an hour. Not a lot of movement there, but it's right on a dime.
Comes back with a fastball again as he's in control, 0-2. Here's a ground ball now through the hole into left, and they've got something cooking here. Back-to-back singles to lead off the inning. Manny Machado will take his first swings here, and as you can see, not a lot going right for him offensively here in this first month of the year. And this will stay inside the third base bag, a fair ball. He will score as Machado delivers the RBI. We're even at one apiece. Matt Wieters will stand in for the first time, currently third in the league in RBIs. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Now a swing and a ground ball. And this is past him at third, down the line. It's a fair ball. He will score, and the Orioles have taken the lead. It's 2-1. Luis Valbuena will stand in. A couple of hits in that ball game last night. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Would you say he's not really finishing his pitches at this point?
That's a good way to put it. It looks like he's aiming a little too much, and that's not working for him.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And Markakis won't get there. It's a foul ball. And he didn't quite get all of it as this is lifted in the air out towards left center. And that is down for extra bases as this will get one home and maybe two. And a relay to the plate. He will score, and the O's add another to their lead. It's now 4-1. Jonathan Spahn is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
That's not really a bad take that time. You've got a guy out there on the mound that's had his hands full already, so you've got to make him prove that he can find the zone.
And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. Only play will be to the pitcher covering, and the runner will advance to third now. Michael Kadire will try his luck now with four runs already home and a chance to make it five with a fly ball here. Runner away from third, now the pitch. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Here's a swing and a foul ball. On Kadire swings and misses here as he's down on strikes for the second out. Chris Davis will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. Runner away from third, now the pitch. That's taken, now it's 0-2.
Probably his best located pitch so far. Right on the outside corner, and that's the spot he's going to need to start finding.
And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Adam Jones makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. And no swing, apparently. Ball one.
It looked like he was going to try to go the other way with that thing, but a wise idea there to try to hold up.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Swing and a high chopper. And he's retired, one away. J.J. Hardy will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. That pitch count, as you see, already standing at 41.
And you don't need Eric or I to tell you about that. That's way too many this early.
And this is going to be a foul ball.
Hey, let her fly up there, huh?
Hey, see you out there. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. There to get it is Pedroia. On to first as the throw takes care of Hardy, two away. Nolan Reimold will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
Yeah, he came with a little bit of a different look that time. This pitch is also in there knee high.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire. Manny Machado will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. First pitch is a changeup for a called strike. Fouled back. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. One gone in the inning. Here's the catcher, Matt Wieters. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
Sticks with the fastball here as he forges ahead 0-2. Still sticking with the fastball, but this time he lays off. It's 1-2.
Such a tough pitch to lay off there. The two-seamer working away with two strikes, but he lets it go. Maybe just because he knew he couldn't hit it.
Four runs, six hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
Up next for the Orioles, second baseman.
Luis Valbuena is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. And with two away here, this is not the time to lose the strike zone.
Especially not to a number nine hitter. The last thing you want to do is turn this lineup over and give these guys a shot to make something out of this inning after all.
2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. 4-1 our score as we play inning number four. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Jonathan Spahn will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Fastball in there for a called strike.
And this is a really important inning for him right here. Your guys go out there and get you a couple runs. You want to throw up a zero, come back in and see if they can't get you some more.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ballgame.
The right fielder, number three, Michael Kadire.
Michael Kadire is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. And this is fouled back and out of play. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. He'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Chris Davis will stand in now. A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick or
or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game. You'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. Here's another 0-2. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Too high. 1-2.
And this guy won't lay down here because there's two outs and nobody on. He's putting up a good fight.
Now here's a swing and a ground ball. A few steps to his left. He's got it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Adam Jones will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Sliced hard but foul. Look out over there. And now here's the ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. Throw into second, but he'll be in there with a double. Here comes Sox manager John Farrell on his way out to the mound. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. And quite a lot of offense in this one, but if we had to highlight one guy that made the difference, there he is. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a couple of hits, but more importantly, that big home run, which really...
The Winkies beating on my window. I haven't slept all night. That drum just keeps on banging. They must be buzzing at the mind. Life is in a half. Tell me when the morning arrives. This place is just not for me. I say it all the time. My friends, they just ignore my time and never mind. We know your life for a slow bill sunrise. Upon the concrete, the dirt is in my mouth. I clench my fists and feet. I'm trying to cry out loud, make a sound. Something is keeping me down. This place is just not for me. I say it a thousand times. My friends, they just ignore me. Tell me never mind. Waiting on your life on some new sunrise.
Take